Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to City Week. Now I am being joined by, to my far left, one of the ladies that helped with all the costume design, Goose Boudreaux. Goose, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
Well, it's a pleasure to have you here. I got an opportunity to talk. So I'm going to, Ken, you just hold tight for a moment. I want to talk to Goose for a moment, if you don't mind. Goose, if you don't mind, tell us a little bit about yourself. We were talking before you came on. You were sharing some interesting things. So if you don't mind, tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm from New Orleans. Raised my daughter there. Uh-huh. Lived in the French Quarter. And worked with a lot of different Mardi Gras associations.
Okay.
And the things that I did for them was set up associations, new associations, and the costuming. And the costuming of the king and queen, which is a major event, uh-huh. because the costuming is so elaborate. And we wanted to bring that same costuming to LaGrange.
Okay. So we're looking forward to it. I'm going to come back to you in just a moment, if you don't mind. But, you know, Ken, when we left off, we were talking about some of the entries that are going to be in the parade. You got the 1974 entry that will be done by the band out of Little Five Points. And you were talking before we left, too, about when you came here and you wanted to make, you know, things to be thrown from the parade. You found out pretty quickly, we don't do that here.
That was surprising.
That was surprising.
That was very surprising.
That's right.
It was like, wait, we got beads. We've got little kids that want to throw beads. Uh-huh. Why not? And we ran into a bunch of discussions on safety and things like that. But what I actually found out, it was actually cultural. Uh-huh. And depending on where you grew up, you had this attitude about beads. The dangerous thing when you think about it is the float.
Yeah.
So we try to make safety a big part of things, and mm-hmm. we try to make sure that it's safe. That is a very important concern in doing a parade. We try for safety. So that means that most of the crew floats, you'll notice, have railings up to keep people safe from the wheels and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
I was surprised, and going into it, I had to make the case that this could be done correctly, and we've been working on that and making it fun. And the thing is, there's more of a human connection when you're throwing things. You know, when you're in a parade and you wave to someone and someone waves back, there's a little bit of a connection there.
Mm-hmm.
But when you see someone and you want to throw them a thing and they want to catch it, there's this more intense connection that happens. And sometimes you don't get them on the first one or the second one, and you take a bunch of stuff and throw it out. It's like, you got it. You know, it's just a lot of fun, and everybody enjoys that, and mm-hmm. it's a very interesting dynamic that goes into it. You have to experience it to really understand it.
So you're telling the kids this year, bring backs, right?
Bring backs.
Bring your backs.
Your pockets won't be enough to carry away all the stuff that you catch at the parade.
Uh-huh.
So typically bring at least, you know, a good bag.
Okay. Well, very good. Now, we haven't got, and I was saving this because Goose is the person that is responsible for making sure that the king and queen are in just beautiful, elaborate costume design. Tell us, first of all, who is the king and queen this year?
Our king and queen are Kevin Gordon and Given Sharp.
Okay.
And they will be our youngest king and queens to date.
Mm-hmm.
And they are both college students. And we expect to have just a beautiful king and queen this year.
Okay.
And they have been fitted for their costumes. Their costumes came from major designers in New Orleans and Mississippi. One thing most people don't know is one of the largest costume houses in the country was in Biloxi, Mississippi.
Okay.
And some of their costumes came from that design house.
Okay.
And they were fitted this past week, and they're going to be in full regalia with 12-foot trains and large collars with plumed collars, and we're going to introduce the lace collar this year for the first time. Given will be wearing a lace collar, which has not been seen here to this date.
Okay, very good. That sounds exciting. I remember last, I think, Jim, of course, the mayor, as you were telling me, Ken, when the Mardi Gras parade comes back through, our mayor gets a promotion.
He gets a promotion.
Talk about that, if you don't mind.
He gets to be the Lord Mayor.
Lord Mayor.
And the king and the queen come back and toast the Lord Mayor in front of City Hall and thank him for taking care of LaGrange, which is probably their favorite place in their entire kingdom.
Uh-huh. Absolutely.
And then the next year, they disappear for a while, and the next year, the king and queen come back.
Absolutely.
So it's fun that way.
Fun. And not only do you all have a king and queen, and they'll stop here in front of City Hall, and they'll toast the mayor, but you also have a grand marshal.
Yes.
And talk about our grand marshal for this year.
One of the joys is to recognize the grand marshal, because the grand marshal is someone that a lot of times doesn't get the credit that they deserve. They work and they do a lot of good, but they're not really getting the recognition. And this is our way of just saying, tremendous what you're doing. Patty Youngblood mm-hmm. is our grand marshal. Patty heads the United Way, and she does a lot of work in a lot of areas. She's not afraid to get out and get the job done. And it's like, so Patty deserves a lot of recognition, and I think she's an excellent choice for grand marshal.
Absolutely. I serve on the United Way board, so I echo those sentiments that you say. Patty does a wonderful job here in our community, because it reaches out to so many areas in our community. And talking about, you know, recognition of various things, and then the entries of floats. And I was asking a gentleman, or Ken and Goose, you as well, if there was somebody that was having an entry and they may wanted to talk with you all about maybe being fitted for a costume. Is that possible, Goose?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay.
We will discuss anyone that's interested in an entry.
Okay.
And we can assist them in costuming, and we do have some costumes in-house that we can work with.
Okay. Well, very good. Now, we've talked about this parade for a long time, and I hadn't asked the most important question. Tell everybody when the parade is going to be held and where, if you don't mind, Ken.
It's a night parade. It's going to be on a Saturday night, 7 p.m.
Uh-huh.
It will be on February the 15th,
okay.
2020.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. In downtown LaGrange. And you guys are so unique. You guys get to run your parade in the reverse route.
Right. Well, there's a couple of reasons for that, but one of them is we like to be a little different. So we run it the opposite way from the Christmas parade. But we start at Sweetland, we stage there,
uh-huh.
and then we just start going up Ridley down to the theater, and then we cut over to Bull Street, and then it's more or less a big rectangle back up to Sweetland.
Okay.
But the nice thing about the route is you could catch it on Ridley and then move over a block and then catch it again and double the amount of stuff that you take home.
There you go. Absolutely. Well, you know, our time gets away from it. I want to thank both of you all of you all. Goose, thank you so very much for being here in our community as well. I understand you've been here now almost 5 years, and I hope that you love LaGrange.
Oh, I did.
Well, great. Everybody says this is the greatest little place in America.
It is.
Well, thank you so much for being here. And Ken, thank you and John for bringing Krewe of Mask here to LaGrange so that we get that experience of New Orleans right here in LaGrange, Georgia. I've never been to a Mardi Gras. I always wanted to go when I was in college. Never, I heard so much about it. I'm like, I don't know if I really want to go or not. But we want to thank you all for bringing it here that we can enjoy right here in LaGrange, Georgia, though.
Thank you.
Thank you all for being on the show today, okay?
Thank you.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, stay tuned for more City Week coming up in just a moment.
Show. Very good.